maniacs, witches, radicals, fools, cry the old man with dead minds ruled by their tools. Nymphomaniacs, they call them, their daughters confined to prisons and asylums. Confined. The greedy old men have always been there, wearing the judge's wig or the general's uniform, the inquisitioner's cloak or the psychiatrist's gown, the faceless businessmen who lie through their teeth, who stab in the dark, and all those beneath, in their hierarchy of brutality, their towers of greed, stuffing themselves while millions die in need. The man without ethics makes the best decision, while those with real morals are treated with derision. The best decision, the best decision, the best decision for his company and himself. Dare we call it conspiracy? His old mate happens to be a financier for the military, selling arms, drugs, and debt to the third world and the first. What happened to the second? Well, they coined the words. Another mate owns a university, a place to train bright young minds to give in to authority and worship the hierarchy. They like to share a glass of port and a cigar in the Melbourne clubs of the world. But they have no love, only fear and hate. They hate the young people who won't fight for the queen, corporate structure of capitalism. They hate their long hair, their nose rings and tattoos. They hate their indifference to entrenched taboos. Drug addicts and hippies that have the whole lot put down, euthanized, put away, at least, trolled with an armed police full of young thugs and a judicial system that calls people mugs. A psychiatric system that tortures and torments. Philosophers and artists tell me, who is bent? They tell me, who is bent? They say it's simple, these people are mad with an incurable illness, a defectiveness. It really, really is sad. What can we do in our position of control but label them publicly and give them the treatment they deserve? Electric shocks, humiliation, and drugs that cripple. Encouraging them to kill themselves is surely better than losing our position, our position, our position, our position, our position. Opposition is this: the lies at the root of the eugenics movement are delusions of grandeur that justify torment. Stigmatized youngsters suiciding in masses, the murderers make sure they're seen in the churches. But when will it end, this illusion that they've built? An illusion of fairness, justice, and freedom. Fairness, justice, and freedom. In a land where one leader told us life was not meant to be easy, another, I am an Englishman always. Yet another, no child will live in poverty. No child will live in poverty. When will the illusion be revealed as such? Illusion shown to be running amok. Down narrow corridors with narrow minds, a preoccupation with statistics and meaningless point scoring, a preoccupation with slavery and debt reduction. A debt to who? I'd like to know. A debt to who? I'd like to know. Exploiters, enslavers, mass murderers, and worse. A debt. A debt to these men, the The madmen in office continue to argue about which party is better. Which party? About marginal seats while marginalized people weep silently for what was once a lucky country. What was once a lucky country. What was once a lucky country. A lucky country. Before it was colonized by barbaric people who shout at each other, shouting they're the best, that they're the strongest, beating their chests like baboons, baboons in ties, old school ties, 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 old school ties, old school ties.